Well, nothing wrong with that. Okay, then the birds are good for something, right?
I mean,
that's great, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I agree with you. Thanks for the call. George, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Hey, Dave, how's it going tonight?
Pretty good. George, how's it going with you?
Fine. I agree with you totally on this makeup deal.
You do?
Yeah.
I appreciate having a man like you agree with me. I like that.
Thanks.
Makes me feel good.
I don't think a woman should wear makeup. You're either pretty or you're just not so pretty, and you have to live with that fact.
Simple as that. Simple as that. I mean, I don't think I could word any. You're either pretty or you're not pretty.
Yeah.
Right? And just as simple as that.
Yeah.
And if you're pretty, you don't need makeup. You're not pretty, live with it. Right?
Yeah.
Maybe life will be better. You know, when reincarnation comes around, you know, I don't know, right?
Yeah, I think it's kind of wrong to fool a guy. You're not that pretty, and you put on makeup, you get home, and...
Well, what happens? What happens if I'm wearing a $60 shirt?
Yeah.
You know, us guys, we wear good shirts, right?
Yeah.
I might have them on a $60 white shirt, you know, with a big puff sleeve, right?
Yeah.
So I got this girl on my arm. She's resting her head on me, just kind of admiring me. You know what I mean? And some of that makeup gets on my shirt and ruins my shirt.
Yeah, then you got to pay for it to be dry cleaned.
Well, just what if it doesn't come out?
Yeah.
Right?
Got to buy a new shirt.
Got to buy a new shirt. So was it worth it? Heck no, it wasn't worth it, right?
Yeah. Especially when you find out if she takes off her makeup, she's not really that pretty.
Thank you, George.
You're welcome.
Great point. It was a great point. All right, who to next? Let's go to Vince. Hey, Vince.
Yeah, I would just like to say that I believe that certain animals do have rights.
Name.
Like your pets, I mean, like if you was hungry, you wouldn't, like, go to your aquarium and grab a goldfish.
Want to bet? I've never been hungry, so I don't know. I mean, I've always been able to quench my hunger by going to a fast food joint. But if I was extremely hungry, no, your dog in your backyard would not be safe. I have never been hungry.
Well,
yes.
A cow was put here to eat.
So
a dog was put here to be your friend.
Oh, give me a break. They, on the other side of the globe, they eat dogs all the time. The Vietnamese eat them all the time. The Koreans eat them all the time. I mean, they're a delicacy. They look forward to them. I mean, it's good beef. It's good stew. It's your hang-up. I'm not saying let's eat dogs or anything, but, I mean, just, well, it wouldn't bother me if you did. If you said, hey, I ate my dog tonight for supper, I mean, it was great. We had him with biscuits. Who cares? It's a dumb dog.
Yeah, man, but, I mean,
no, I mean,
you take dogs to run a deer, and then you kill the deer and eat the deer.
I agree with that. If you have a dog, I just think all animals were put here for our benefit. All animals were put here for us to use.
Yeah, I believe it.
And I think using animals on research... to make it where I can live a long life and be disease-free is great, don't you?
Yeah.
I mean, does it bother you if they took a dog and here put one German Shepherd next to another German Shepherd and they transplanted hearts and transplanted livers, transplanted stomachs, transplanted...
Oh, no, that's getting out of hand.
That is not getting out of hand. I want young doctors to practice on dogs, not on me.
Well, that's true. But
what do you mean that's true?
That.
Of course that's true. Get with it, man. Get with it. You're a man. Come on. What is this? Come on. My callers, you disgust me. You disgust me. Make me sick to my stomach. You know, I mean, I could have somebody important in my audience driving through Atlanta right now. Right now, he's in his car. He's passing through on 85. He's going to the mountains. He's listening to my talk show, and he's saying, all right, you know, he's from little bitty country town, little bitty Nowheresville down there in Florida. Middle of nowhere over in Louisiana, married to his cousin, you know, he's driving through a big city. He says, hey, I want to see a big-time talk show. I want to hear a big-time talk radio show. That's what he's thinking to himself. And then he's driving through Atlanta, and next thing you know, he's listening, and let me tell you what kind of idiot he is. Let me give you art. Let me find it. Here he's driving through our city, and he says, I want to hear a big-time talk radio show. I want to hear a big-time talk radio show. And this is what he hears. This is the kind of bozo he has to hear. Guys like Barney. Hey, Barney.
Hello, kind sir. How are you?
I'm doing good.
I want to talk about both of your subjects because they are both of interest to me. But the first one...
Just a second. People, do you hear what I'm saying? Do you hear what the... Right now, somebody's driving to Atlanta, and they're listening to this bozo. They're listening to this...
I wanted to talk about hunting because I think you are absolutely right.
I'm always right.
I think people should be able to blast Bambi's brains out.
So do I.
I don't understand why they don't want to blow away Bugs Bunny.
Who cares?
I know we could do in
Porky Pig. I mean, we eat Porky Pig. What's the big deal, right?
That's right. I agree with you 100%.
Right.
You are very good. But I would like to talk about women who wear makeup.
Please, please.
And you were talking about it. I would never let my wife wear makeup. One time she put on makeup, and I tell you, she looked like a woman with loose morals.
Loose morals.
Yes. She looked like a...
Everybody listen at it. Loose morals.
Yes. Floozy. She looked like a floozy.
Looked like a floozy.
A sleaze.
A
slut. A stupid hussy she looked like. Yes, sir. A prostitute, sir. That's what she looked like.
Because she was wearing makeup.
Yes, she wore makeup. She looked like a whore, a tramp, sir.
Your wife did.
Well, she did. I made her get it off.
Right.
But I've been listening to you, sir, and I just want to tell you, kind sir, that I think everything you say is absolutely positively correct.
Well, thank you.
You should run for, like, a governor or something of the state. Well, the elections are over, but...
Well, thank you very much.
But I can see that you are a very bright man. And
thank you.
They should put you on the daytime, not the overnight stuff.
Well, thank you very much.
Okay, sir.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that. I appreciate that. Thank you very much. Yes. What a good guy. Yes. Very bright. Very, very, very knowledgeable caller. 872-0750. Outside of Atlanta, 1-800-WSB-TALK. I'm David Paul. This is AM 750 WSB.
Sunday, the Falcons fly again. This time into New Orleans.
Go to Stripes. Hey, Stripes, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Hey.
Hey.
This is Stripes. I'm a friend of Stars. You know him, don't you?
Yeah, you're a real redneck, yeah.
Yeah, he's a redneck.
Right, what's going on?
I just want to say, hey, man, everything that you're saying is okay.
That's why
you're a positive dude.
That's right. I'm very positive. I'm a motivator. How to win friends and influence people, that's my middle name.
Hey, the only animals that you're dealing with is these two brain cell dudes that you've been talking to for the past hour and a half, 2 hours.
It's like I'm fly paper, yes.
You know what I mean?
I know exactly, yeah. Animals are here to serve me.
Is that just like women?
Just like...
You gotta be careful on that one.
Yes, I do.
The makeup deal.
Yeah.
You know, most of them women, you ask them, say, look, man, did the streetlight come with that outfit or what, you know? Most of them that wear that's what you're dealing with.
That says, you're right. I don't know. What do I know? I don't know. See, I know what I read and what I study, and I've researched this subject for about a week before I brought it up tonight.
Uh-huh.
And it's a test, litmus test. Either you have brains, you don't have brains, and if you wear a lot of makeup, you don't have brains. If you don't wear makeup, you're a bright person like Sandra Day O'Connor. It's just, I didn't make up the test. It's a proven test, and it's just, that's the way it is, right?
Right.
And I don't mean to point fingers or anything, and I'm not here to judge, but that's true, right?
You speak the truth.
That's why I say it. That's my goal in life.
Yeah.
Right, Stripes?
I hear you.
Thanks for calling me, Stripes.
All righty, man.
Nice to meet you.
You too. I'm borrowing his car. I'm riding around Atlanta with it. You don't know I got it, though.
Oh, no. See you later.
See you, mate.
Chris, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Hey, Dave.
Hey, Chris.
I'm going to take a pro and con situation on this makeup ordeal.
Split.
First of all, I feel that some women is able to justify that they wear makeup because, for instance, Michelle Pfeiffer, I saw her without any makeup, and she looks like a dog. She just, it's not her.
Not possible. No. Come on, not possible. Michelle, No.
I'm sorry to say, but...
No, not possible. Michelle Pfeiffer? No, I'm in love with that chick, man.
She does not look good without any makeup. She looks old, she looks all baggy.
No, where did you see her without makeup?
I saw her without makeup on the making of the Fabulous Baker Boys.
Oh, no. You don't know what you were saying. You had a fuzzy TV or something. But no, Michelle Pfeiffer, she's never looked bad in her life. And I don't appreciate a guy like you calling me up and telling me somebody I really care about looks bad without makeup.
That's just too bad.
I don't appreciate it. Thanks for the call. See you later. Let's go to Dan. Hey, Dan.
Hey, Dave.
Hey, Dan.
Did you say that goofy people wear makeup?
No, too much makeup. You can wear a little makeup. That is fine. But once I can tell you're wearing makeup, that is wrong, and Dave Paul does not approve.
Does that explain why our wife wears makeup?
Give me a break, twit. Let's go to Renee. Hey, Renee. Renee.
Yeah?
You're on the radio, Renee. Figure it out.
Really?
Yes.
Well, I just wanted to say, you know, like a couple things to you. And one, I think you were totally wrong with everything that you had said all night.
I said my name is David Paul. Is that wrong?
I said this is AM 750
WSB. Is that wrong?
I don't know. Is it?
Of course it's not. So you're wrong. But what you said is not everything.
Hell now.
Well, you just said everything I said is wrong, and everything I said is not wrong.
Well, minus the little basic details.
Well, what do you want? Why are you bugging me on my job? I'm working right now. I'm earning a living. Why are you bothering me?
Because I think you're wrong on everything you say. I don't think you have not one idea of what you're talking about, saying animals don't have any rights at all.
Well, name a right they have.
They have a right to live.
No.
And they have a right not to take crap off people like you.
Well, you going to put me in jail if I go out there and shoot a squirrel and eat it for supper tomorrow night?
I don't know, but I think somebody should.
Oh, give me a break.
You have had a break all your life, and it's time to start facing reality.
I do face reality.
Do you?
Yeah, I realize there's a lot of nitwits in the world like you. That's reality.
Nitwit? I think I have a lot more common sense than you could even hope to have.
You do?
Yeah.
Does it bother you when you walk through a grocery store and there's all the meat department, all that meat looking at you?
Yes, it does. I think it's disgusting.
Oh, you poor, sad little creature. It's too bad that life is so easy for you. Life to you is so basic. I mean, you don't see the real problems. You look at the insignificant little things like the rights of a dumb animal. The rights of a dumb animal are important to you.
You are a dumb animal.
I beg your pardon?
You should.
I should what? Beg your pardon?
Yes, you should.
Are you trying to confuse me?
It's so easy.
No, it's not easy. It's very difficult to confuse me.
Is it?
What do you want? Why are you...
I already told you what I wanted.
You did?
Yes, I wanted to tell you how wrong you are. I think you know how wrong you are.
Hey, Paul. Renee.
Yes?
It's been very nice meeting you. Call me again.
I will.
Bye, Renee.
Bye.
The people I have to put up with. People are cruising through our city right now. This is the first time they've ever heard AM 750 WSB. And they have to listen to you. You the caller. You ignorant. You dumb. Please, let's change that. The next hour, let's have a little higher quality. Animals have no rights. Animals are here to serve man. Serve the master. That is what an animal's for. I'm David Paul. This is AM 750 WSB.
Hi, it's mine. Yeah. See, I think that women shouldn't be able to make up themselves.
Why, Doug? Why? Mm-hmm. Tell me why, Doug. Why? In your own words, I want you to take it easy right now. Slow down. Tell me in your own words, Doug, why?
Well, I tell you, if I was a woman, I should wear it because that's what makes the skin look old. Cause
Doug, well put. I don't think anybody could have worded it better than you.
Yeah, that clogs up the pores of the skin. That's why God made the skin with pores open.
You're a very...
Air and stuff.
Pores and... You're a very well-read man, I can tell. Thanks for calling, Doug.
You're welcome. Have a good night.
Oh, I will, Doug. See you later. Yes, Doug, absolutely, yes. To the phones and talk to Sandy. Hello, Sandy.
Hello.
Well, hello.
I'm listening.
What are you listening? What do you want me to...
I'm listening to your radio show, for one thing.
Thank you so much. It means an awful lot to a guy like me. Yes. And what do you want?
Well, what I called about is I want to make a comment as far as the makeup thing goes.
Makeup,
and
no.
Another thing. I'm really appalled at some of the people that call in about makeup.
So
they really don't understand. You know, women, it's drummed into them all their life to be pretty for a man. Okay?
Makeup's like a padded bra.
Right. But I'm saying it's drummed into you to look nice for a man.
What do you do to look nice for your man?
Well, I try to wear makeup, too, and I guess maybe you think that's wrong.
Well, no, I mean, I appreciate the effort. I am worth it. You know, and I appreciate you going out of your way to spruce yourself up. You may need to be spruce yourself up, right?
Well, yeah.
Because you have been, maybe you've been dealt from the bottom of the deck. You know what I mean?
Well, I wouldn't put it that way. I don't think I'm God's ugliest creature on earth, but I may not be his prettiest either.
Okay.
The point I'm trying to get across is women sometimes wear makeup to hide flaws that they've got, okay?
What kind of flaws do you have?
I'm not saying I have any. I'm saying some women do.
You have a big nose?
No, I don't have a big nose.
Okay. You have a chin, don't you?
Yeah, I have a chin.
Okay.
I have two eyes.
See, you have everything you need.
Yeah, that's right.
Right?
But I'm pale.
You're pale.
Right.
Why don't you stand out?
You get in the sun too much, and that gives you skin cancer.
Well, I'm pale, too. I don't believe the sun's bad for you. I mean, tan, there's no such thing as a healthy tan.
Well, let me ask you this.
Yes?
Most of the guys out there in this world can't accept a woman without makeup. They can't accept her the way she is. They look for what's on the outside.
I am not saying go without makeup. Because
right.
I think you should do something to make yourself look dainty and delicate for your man.
Mm-hmm.
But you don't make it where it's obvious you're wearing makeup, right?
Right.
I mean, I don't like big circles on each cheek, do you?
No, but I sometimes get them when I get in a hurry.
Big circles, and it's to me, it's like you're halfway through putting on your clown costume, you know, and you're getting ready to go trick-or-treating or something. I don't like that look. It looks fake. It looks like you have two big circles on each cheek.
But women are approached by men all the time, and they can't accept what's on the outside. They don't give it time enough to find out what that person's really like underneath.
Oh, you mean they just want you for your body?
Right.
What's wrong with that? Because you want the guy for his body.
I don't.
Oh, yes, you
do. I know. I'm different.
Well,
I admire a nice-looking body on a man, but I don't want a man for his body.
What do you want him for? Financial support?
No.
What do you want him for?
I want him for companionship, somebody to have fun with and enjoy doing things with.
You have a guy in your
sex
life?
Sex is not the major thing on the top of my list.
Sex is everything.
No, it may be to you, but it's not to me.
Well, it's getting to know somebody. It's everything.
You don't get to know somebody by going to bed with them.
Well, I don't know. I mean,
start from the end and go to the beginning.
How would I know?
I don't know. How would you know?
Well, you're right. I wouldn't know. I mean, that's... No, I've been married so long. How would I know? You're asking the wrong person. Are you single?
Yes, I'm single.
Well, I'm asking the right person then, aren't I?
For a very good reason, because I don't go out and sleep with every man I meet.
Well, thank goodness for that. You'd probably be dead by now if you did.
I probably would.
I mean, a lot of diseases out there, right?
Right.
Right. So how long do you date a guy?
Well, the last one for 3 weeks.
What happened?
It seemed like that was the major thing on the top of his list.
And what was your opinion of it?
My opinion of it?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I just told him what was what. I told him it wasn't the most important thing in my life.
Where does it rank? Mm-hmm.
He would have done it sooner or later. He would have walked out on me anyway.
So you kept your guard up.
Right, and I've still got my guard up.
Well, that's good. That's good, because I feel like a guy that really cares about you will wait around. He'll get
right
to know you personally, and it's...
But I've had a lot of guys comment to me, you know, some comment about how your makeup looks very nice, and others comment
mm-hmm.
about you wear too much. But then when you try to get to know somebody, it seems like they can't get past that. If they were to walk into your house and see you without makeup, you'd probably scare them to death.
Probably.
That's the point I'm trying to make.
Yeah,
men are out
yeah.
there looking for what's on the outside, not what's underneath.
I agree with, but see, that's always the first impression. But once you get past that, they'll get to know you personally.
Right.
But a lot of girls are out there looking for the Tom Selleck
too. Well, sure, there are a lot of girls out there, and I admire a nice body and a nice-looking man myself,
mm-hmm.
but I don't want to spend the rest of my life with a nice-looking, dumb, stupid man.
No, you don't. You want somebody you can sit across the table from and have a nice chit-chat.
Right.
And talk for hours and hours.
Right.
Right?
That's true.
Nice to meet you, Sandy.
Something else I did want to
say. Oh, yes, go ahead.
And I don't want to sound too ugly about this.
Oh, please.
A lot of times people call in.
Yes.
And you're very sarcastic and rude to them, and I don't understand why you do that. Maybe it's just
you.
I wonder if you're really like that outside of that place.
Yes, I am. I'm very rude.
Why are you like that?
Because it's just me. In fact, I have people that can't stand it about me, but just that's the way I am. That's me personally. And just if you wanted to be around me on a regular basis, you'd have to understand that and live with it. And after a while, it'd bounce right off. You wouldn't even care. Know what I mean? It would be ineffective. Like, it's ineffective with my wife. I get up in the morning and say, hey, you look like hell, honey. Put some, you know, do something. Take a shower or something. You make me sick, you know? And just, she doesn't understand. You know, it doesn't bother her at all anymore. Know what I mean?
Well, she must really love you.
No, not really. Not real. Thanks for the call.
Thank you.
No, I'm not rude. I'm really not rude. I'm a nice guy.
Well, I've listened to your radio show for a long time.
I am rude.
And a lot of times I've wanted to just, you know, I'd like to have rang your neck.
Well, I'm rude to dumb people. So what? Aren't you ever rude?
Yeah.
I mean, there's a lot of ignorant people out there, and I'm rude to them. So what?
Yeah, but
What's the big deal?
They're ignorant a lot of times. Don't tell them.
Oh, okay.
Let them stay in hiding.
Thanks for the call.
You're welcome.
Bye. Let's go next to Chris. Hey, Chris. Chris. You're on the radio, Chris. Last chance, Chris. Let's go next to, how about Jamie? Hey, Jamie.
Dave.
Jamie.
How are you, sir?
Is that your name, Jamie?
That's right.
What's happening?
All right, listen, as far as being sarcastic, man, I think you're doing a heck of a job.
I don't think there is such a word.
I don't think there is either.
Nah, you just...
And I tell you what, you've had a lot of bimbos call in tonight.
No, man, I get bimbos, I get drunks, I get drug addicts, I get losers, I get it all. And just, I mean, there's very few people like you out there, Jamie, who have got something really going for it. You know what I mean?
That's right.
And I just tell it like it is.
I'm not the best kind of person, but
I'm not
a drug addict, and I'm not a wife beater and everything.
Oh,
but...
no, you're not a wife beater?
No,
did you cure that problem or something? What'd you get?
Well, I've only been married for about 2.5 weeks.
Did you seek help or something? Oh, yeah. Wait, you've been married a year.
Well, I figure I got a chance. I've only been married about 2.5 weeks, and I've only tried to kill her 3 times.
You've been married 2.5 weeks?
Yeah.
Now you're avoiding her, right? You're up at 2:15 in the morning. You refused. It's obvious here you have marital problems.
Well, no.
Well, what's the problem?
Well, I work evenings. As a matter of fact, I work for somebody you probably know in the office.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, really?
Well, you know.
Well, I'm not.
No Ludlow, baby.
Oh, yeah, right.
Well, I, in a roundabout way, work for Ludlow.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
A lot of people work for Ludlow. He's a major employer around here, yeah.
Yeah, he is.
Yes, he is. Okay, good.
So, I'll tell you what, you know, as far as these women wearing makeup and stuff, that's just nasty stuff. I mean, a little bit of makeup's all right.
That's the way I look at it.
Todd called and said his girlfriend or somebody was in the bathroom putting makeup on for 10 or 20 minutes. I've known girls that have been in a bathroom for hours putting that stuff on.
Of course, you know, I take a 2-hour shower. I mean, you know, I'm in the bathroom 2 hours too, aren't you?
Well, you know, I'm a clean kind of guy. I mean, I take 2 showers a day.
That's where I do all my thinking for my talk show. I sit in the shower for an hour, and all the mildew takes all the wallpaper off the walls, and it's fun. Thanks for the call.
See you
later, man. Let's go next to Tim. Hey, or is it Jim?
Hey.
Hey.
Am I there?
Yes, you are there. Are you there?
David, are you there?
Somewhat.
Well, listen, I got a beef to talk to you about.
Well, please,
makeup stuff.
Talk about your beef, yes.
I mean, don't you have anything better to talk about than makeup on women?
Nope.
I mean, my God. Isn't there a crisis in the Middle East that we can talk about?
Who cares? Nobody cares. I sure don't. Do you care?
You don't care?
Oh, give me a break. You're an idiot, man. What is this? I'm not talking to idiots. Come on. You want to talk 7 days a week about the crisis? Give me a break. Come on. Give me anything other than a moron, a complete bore. This guy must be a bore. If, buddy, you have a need to talk to me, do you sit around? It's obvious you don't have any women, because you'd be with your women saying, oh, we just got to talk about this crisis. You got to get up in the morning and talk about the crisis. You are a complete bore. I'm not talking about the crisis. You complete idiot.
AM 750 WSB is the only station with our own traffic helicopter and airplane. And at AM 750 WSB, you really do hear two reporters, Scott Slade and Joy Cashin. Did you know other stations actually share the same reporter? And he's just too busy to report traffic every 6 minutes. Nobody else has skycopter and skyplane traffic. AM 750 WSB. Depend on it.
The biggest sale of the year at Tinkers 2 is this Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. The Tinkers 2 offers not only the most unique gifts in the city, this weekend only, they're practically giving away many of the fine Irish imported items in the store. Selected capes, scarves, and sweaters are an incredible 40% off. All hand-cut Irish crystal is a full 20% off. The Tinkers 2 also has a terrific selection of Irish linens and jewelry. If it's stocking stuffers you're looking for, the Tinkers 2 is the place to find them. Irish perfume, cologne, artwork, books, and tapes make great treats for a special someone's Christmas stocking. So why fight the the crowds at the mall and settle for the same old thing when you can find unusual gifts and amazingly low prices this Friday, Saturday, and Sunday at the Tinker's 2. The Tinker's 2 will be open from 10 till 10 this weekend during this special sale. So visit Atlanta's only Irish importer at 776 North Highland in the heart of Virginia Highlands, just off St. Charles.
Welcome back, Mr. Personality here, Dave Paul. Around the station, they call me Mr. Talk Radio. That's what I'm about, man. That's my middle name, Talk Radio. Educationalist. They call me that, too. Yeah, that's me. Let's go to Joe. Hey, Joe.
Hello, Dave.
Hey, Joe.
Got a good show tonight.
Well, thank you so much.
I have to agree with everything you said so far.
Oh, I'm an itch. I mean, you're learning something, aren't you?
Well, I already knew it. Didn't have to learn.
Well, yeah, that's the secret about education, yes. They feel like they already... Yeah, right. You go ahead.
You know, if the truth hurts...
Do I interrupt you when I speak like this? Does that bother you?
Nope.
Sorry, go ahead.
Well, you know, some of these people that call in to say you're hurting animals and their rights and everything, yep. I think they've been watching too many cartoons.
Well, that's what I think. You've been watching too many cartoons. I mean, yeah. Animal's an animal. Come on.
You're going to tell me that if two people are starving, somebody's going to go over and eat berries and grass, you know, and here comes a deer across the way, you know, you're going to make that choice.
Right, right.
You know,
no, just, that deer has rights.
Oh, yes,
yeah,
definitely.
Yeah, I know what his right is. His right is he's got to feed me. That's his right, yeah. No, I mean, yeah, and then I'm going to want to wear his coat, and yeah, right.
Yeah, no, survival of the fittest.
Oh, come
on. The strong survive, man.
Animals are here to make my life easier.
Yeah.
That is their sole purpose for existence.
I wanted to make another comment on the makeup thing.
Oh, please, yes. I'd love to hear it.
You said you got a survey. What was the survey?
Survey?
Yeah.
Did I say something about a survey?
Well, it was something you read or something.
Yeah. I just doggone it. I misplaced it.
It was, maybe if I didn't remember how you, I was trying to think how you exactly said it.
Yeah.
So I wouldn't misquote you.
Oh, I think I just doggone it. I must have misplaced
it. It was about, let me think a minute. It was about that if a girl wears more makeup, she's dumb or something?
Oh, no. It's just, there's yes, right. Something I read. I wish I could tell you where I read it. So.
Well, here it seems like, here again, the male species comes out again as a winner because if a man wore lipstick and makeup, you know, what would society considering?
Well, I know what I'm considering.
Well, I do too.
Right. Thanks for the call, Joe.
All right.
See you later. Another Joe. Hey, Joe.
Hello there.
Hey.
How are you tonight?
Pretty good. How about you?
Doing fine.
Good.
You know what really galls me?
No, Joe.
Right to the bone is when you go out with a girl.
Right.
And you catch her in a romantic moonlight.
Right.
And you catch her makeup line under her chin and her face and her neck are two different colors. You know, they got pancake makeup on one and another kind of makeup on the other.
There's like a circle going from ear to ear. Yeah,
I know
what you're talking about.
You want to get a gallon of Pond's cold cream and scrub them down and see what you're going out with.
So let me clean you up a little bit.
Yeah.
Right, you know, they went to the circus earlier or something. Now, yeah, I know what you mean. I've seen it all the time.
They're macaroons, man. They're crazy.
I don't know why they do it. I mean, they should have see, you don't have a need to change your face, do you? No.
Heck no, it wouldn't do any good anyway.
No, right, probably not. But no, I do not have a need. I mean, I am me. You will take me for me, or you will not take me at all, right?
Right, it's all trappings. They like to wrap themselves up as a gift.
Well, I mean, we are worth it, though, aren't we?
I'd like to think so.
All right, thanks for the call, Joe.
Okay, see you later.
See you later, man. Let's go to Ellen. Hey, Ellen.
Hey, Dave.
Hello.
How you doing?
Pretty good. How about you, Ellen?
Oh, I'm doing pretty good. I just want to tell you, we listen to your show a lot, my fiance and myself.
Really?
And he got off work about 30 minutes ago, and I was already sleeping, and he woke me up so we could listen to your show.
That's why he woke you up?
Well
boy, he's a bore.
That's what he said. Hey, and also, we got engaged a month ago, and a couple weeks ago, he called you up.
Yeah.
And you called him an idiot. It was really funny. You hung up on him and called him an idiot.
Well, he probably was.
Well, yeah, he can be sometimes.
Yeah. So,
hey.
So do you two live together?
Uh-huh.
That's sick.
Well, let's not talk about that. Hey, I wanted to ask you a question, though.
Why not? Are you embarrassed about it?
Well, we are going to get married. You know, it's just the situation. You know,
well, I live together, too. I mean, my wife and I live together, too. So what, right?
Well,
I would not marry somebody I did not live with.
Right.
Would you?
Well, do you think it helps a relationship if you live with someone before you get married?
Why not? What's the big? If you're going to marry, why not live together?
Right. You know, I think that's a trend these days. And also, what I was thinking is possibly this will lower the divorce rate because people are living together and they're saying, well, you know, maybe I'll go ahead and marry them. I see how they are to live with them.
How long have you lived together?
1 year and 2 months.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
How long have you been planning marriage?
I'm not sure how long he's been planning on it. He bought the ring back in February,
mm-hmm.
and took his parents with him to get the ring and everything. And, you know, he'd asked me, you know, he wanted to see what my response was going to be, but he didn't formally ask me. It was October 23rd that he formally asked me.
How long did you know each other before you lived together? Yes.
This is kind of funny. I mean, we have been together almost every night since the first night we met.
What?
It was pretty much, you know, it's just the way it happened.
You mean,
we get along perfectly.
Wait a minute. You met each other and went home together.
Uh-huh.
And you've been together ever since.
Uh-huh.
Boy, that's quick.
Well, you know, but, you know, things are working out really good. You know, we have a couple problems, but everything pretty much goes smoothly.
Does it really?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's good.
But I got a question for you
off
the subject.
Sure, sure.
What do you think about colors of lipstick? Like, do you like the orange? Do you like the bright red? Do you like the pink? Do you like just the clear lip gloss?
I like just the clear lip gloss.
Mm-hmm.
Why? What do you like?
Well, I like the clear lip gloss, and
mm-hmm.
then I also like pink. But if I'm wearing a red dress, I like to put on, you know, a red lipstick. But my fiance freaks out.
Mm-hmm.
He says, gross, take that off. Okay, but then sometimes I'll sneak it and wear it to work and not let him see me in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
And the guys, they just say, oh, you look so beautiful. I don't know if they're saying that to be, you know, smart or what. They just rave on and on.
That's because you're cute. And you look good, right? You have a good look? You look good?
Well, I like the way I look.
How old are you?
I'm 25.
25? Oh, an older woman.
Well.
No, 25. No, it's just they. Well, I mean, they look at you as a sex object. And that's why the lipstick looks good. They're looking at you as a sex object.
You think so?
Of course they are. All guys look at women as sex objects. That's what all guys do it.
Uh-huh.
I mean, they don't respect you as a human being. Give me a break.
Yeah, I know. That's why I'm not with any of them. And I'm
right. Well, I mean, that's true, though. Isn't that true? I mean, who cares what she knows? You know, what does she look like?
Yeah, that's true.
But that is true.
Mm-hmm.
Nice to meet you. Thanks for calling.
All right, talk to you later.
See ya. Go next to Mark. Hey, Mark.
Dave, what's going on?
Just partying on the radio.
I was out. I just came in.
Yeah.
And I said, you had to be getting bashed. Are you?
I never get bashed, man. I'm in complete control of my radio show.
Because any time you come out and you tell the truth,
yeah,
people just get so upset about it.
Mark, that's true. You're right.
Animals?
Right, animals.
What are animals? You know, dogs are good for one thing, if they can go get my newspaper.
And right.
If he can't, he's worthless.
You're right. It bothers me when somebody locks a dog in the backyard and there's some sort of benefit from this. Well, where's the benefit?
Really? And this really gets under my skin. I go out and I go to buy some shrimp, right?
Right.
I got to pay more for shrimp because these buffoons out there want to save the turtle. They want to save the dolphin because the big nets are catching everything. Well, so what? Cook the turtle, too.
I was reading in the paper today, and they were talking about these. They have nets now that are 30 miles long. They said it's almost a clear, transparent net. 30
yeah.
miles long. It catches, but people are really complaining because these nets, you know, it's instant. You know, I mean, they kill everything. They catch whales, sharks, dolphins, everything. So what?
So if these animals, if these things swimming around are so dumb not to see this net come,
right.
Why do they need to be living anyway?
Well,
they're serving no purpose.
So what? Right. I mean, I'm not losing any sleep. As long as I go to the market and they keep that fish below 89 cents a pound, what's the big deal?
And birds flying around, all they do is crap on our cars.
Oh, man, come on. You know, I'm doing a benefit if I go out there and shoot them, right?
Shoot the birds out of the sky. I mean, you know, have you ever once been walking around outside and thought to yourself, where are the birds? No, because nobody cares.
We're the birds. You're right.
This makeup thing?
Yes.
This is just another sign of a woman's immense insecurities.
Right.
I mean, they don't fit in already.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they have these little bitty minds, and they have to paint themselves, Dave. They have to go in and just paint themselves. They make their hair defy gravity. And what are they doing?
Mark.
You know, Dave, I bet I bet you heard from just the biggest fruitcakes tonight you ever heard from.
Oh, I get fruitcake. Yes, yes. Especially over the animals. Guys.
The animals, I bet you Bev called crying about the polar bear or something.
They're swearing. Everybody seems to think animals have rights, but I've never seen one written right about an animal. Never, because they don't exist. There's no such thing. An animal never. An animal has rights. Come on, I don't.
People, you can't confuse a normal animal with like a house pet.
Mark,
those pets are domesticated.
Right, Mark. Right.
Right. They don't.
It's been fascinating as usual.
Right, Dave.
Bye, Mark. 872-0750 outside of Atlanta. 1-800-WSB-TALK. I'm David Paul. You're listening to AM 750 WSB.
AM 750 WSB. We're the station that spends more time in every hour on more callers.
2:30 in the morning, people. What the heck are you doing up? And I got cleaning to do around this build, and I got to start cleaning the windows. I don't have time to take phone calls all night. Let's go to Sadie. Hey, Sadie. Sadie. Sadie, turn your radio down in the background, Sadie. Putting you on hold, Sadie. All right, figure it out. Come on, man. This is not dummy's hour. Come on. Turn your radio down in the background before you go on the air. Beth. Hello, Beth.
Hi, David. How are you?
Pretty good, Beth. And how about you, man? How's life with Beth?
Wonderful. Yeah. It sure is.
You up to anything exciting lately?
Well, this is the thing, Dave. You know, I listen to you all the time.
Boy, you're a smart broad. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you. And I'm wondering if you'll listen to me tonight, just for a second. I have this real bad problem that I need some advice.
Oh, that's what I'm all, that's, man, that's my favorite calls. When people ask me for advice, it makes me feel important, you know?
Okay,
please,
let me tell you this
ask
problem
ask me some
I
advice,
have.
Yes, go ahead.
All right. I have this pet dog.
Yes.
And she's beautiful. I love her to death.
Right.
But she wears too much makeup. I'm wondering what I should do about this. Should I, like, eat her?
You're making fun of me.
No, I'm just trying to lighten up the situation, and all these people are calling and getting upset with you.
Okay. How about a real problem? Do you have any real problems?
Oh, I mean, of course some, not.
No problems?
No.
No love problems?
Could I help you solve some problems, maybe?
I don't know. I mean, I got numerous problems, but I didn't really think my audience would really like to hear my problems. But, you know.
Tell me.
Tell you what?
Tell me your problems, Dave. I want to hear them.
Got a bunch of women after me. They want me.
Oh, I know. I've been hearing them all night. See, they act aggressive, but I really think they do want you.
They want my body.
Men are sex objects. I know it.
And it's hard to live with sometimes.
I know.
And I just...
Do you wear a little makeup? That could be it.
I don't wear any makeup. Give me a break. You think I'd wear makeup?
Wow.
I'm Dave Paul. Dave Paul's an example for other men to follow.
Oh.
Do you think I wear makeup?
I was just wondering.
Well, in the right circumstances, I might. I mean, if me and some girl are playing dress-up, you know, I might. I don't know.
Oh, I know. Well, what about, like, do you have a little bit of that whiskers, some little hair on your face? That could be the same as makeup to a girl.
Little whiskers?
Yeah.
I have a mustache.
Like that Don Johnson look?
No, I do not have the Don Johnson look. I can have the Don Johnson look. I mean, I don't know. He's a great-looking guy, and I'm not, no, I'm just very ordinary. I mean, I'm more like, who would I refer to myself? I can't even think of anybody. Nobody looks like me. I'm unique. What about you? Forget me. You're the girl. Nobody cares what I look like. What do you look like?
Well, I just look.
Like what?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Well, I could lie to you, David. You just don't know me.
Are you quality?
Depends. I think I'm quality.
You're quality. There's a girl out there looks like you. Who would it be?
I'd have to say not. She doesn't really act like me, but a lot of people say I look like Mallory on
I know. Yeah, on Family Ties. Mallory. She's got a big mouth.
Yeah.
That's you?
Yeah.
Why do you look like Mallory? You mean you have that look?
I think I have that look.
Well, she's got, her eyes are far apart. That always makes me worry. Whenever I see a girl with eyes far apart.
Yeah, I know what you're saying. My ears are in between my eyes, as a matter of fact. That's how far apart they are.
You have eyes far apart?
Yeah.
It makes me wonder what I'm dealing with here, you know what I mean? Is this girl short of a deck, you know what I mean?
Well, it's okay. I can see behind me.
You can see behind you?
Yeah, yeah.
Ooh.
Some people like that. I don't know.
You're scaring me. You're scaring me. So are you an interesting person? You date a lot or what?
Well, I'm sort of married, but I do date a lot.
Got any boyfriends on the side?
No.
You date a lot. Your husband?
Yeah.
Is he listening to you right now?
I don't know. He's camping.
Oh, he's camping?
You know those men in camping. They're probably, like, putting on makeup and stuff.
Oh, that's sick. He's going out. He's out with the boys?
Yeah.
Now, you married a pervert.
Probably.
I mean, they wanted to get away from everybody else and spend some time with each other. That's sick.
I think that's why I married him.
Because he's a pervert?
Yeah.
Nothing wrong with perversion, man. Perversion makes life interesting. You know what I mean?
Well, listen, David, I just want to say hello. Remember my name, Beth, because I'm going to call you all the time.
Looking forward to it.
All right. Thank you. Have a good night.
Thank you. Bye, Beth.
Bye.
All right. That was Beth, everybody. Let's go to Rick. Hey, Rick.
Hey, Dave.
Hey, Rick.
I'm a Yankee, but I like to say hey once in a while.
I hate Yankees.
Anyhow, a little while ago, you were talking to a girl there. Said she likes to wear lots of makeup.
Yes.
And she also said she's for animal rights.
Oh, God.
I mean, she must be, like, so dumb that she don't realize all that lipstick and all that's made from animal products.
Is it?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, they grind up dead animals and make all that lipstick out of it.
Well, I didn't know that. Is that what lipstick's made out of, ground up animal?
Sure, they use, it's dead animal parts and that stuff.
Well, I didn't know that. Lipstick is ground up animal. I didn't know that.
Yeah, I mean, just so those girls can, look like a bunch of, ugly, greasy tramps with all that makeup on.
No, I mean, I can, if that's the reason, then I congratulate him for using animals. I mean, I congratulate him for wearing makeup. That's what animals are for.
Well,
I mean, whatever benefit we can find. I mean, so
that's one of the strange paradoxes, I suppose.
Lipstick is ground up animal. I didn't know that.
Yeah, they use dead animal products and lipstick and
ground up animal
sorts of makeup.
I didn't know that. Ground up animal. That's fascinating.
Yeah, it's animal products.
Oh, great.
Hey, one more subject we got lost. Lost earlier. We're talking about weightlifters.
Boy, yeah, nobody ever commented on that.
Well, I'd like to make a comment.
Go ahead.
I think, like all these guys stand around and lift weights all the time.
Stupid.
Yeah, I mean, I think they're like a bunch of homosexuals.
You do?
Yeah, I think, like...
Not putting that on the radio, my man. Not putting that on the radio. Nope. Dave Paul has his limitations on what he will put on the radio. 872-0750 is my telephone number. Outside of Atlanta, the number is 1-800-WSB-TALK. Let's go next to Preston. Hey, Preston.
Hey, Dave. How you doing?
Pretty good.
You know what? Some of these women are really pathetic, aren't they?
Yeah, well, some.
Look here, I got an idea.
I'm not doing a women bashing show, and I want to make it very clear, I'm not.
Yeah.
I'm just talking about makeup. I'm talking about the aspect of makeup. Anybody wears makeup, male or female.
Yeah, let me tell you what. I've got an idea. Liable to set us ahead 25 years.
That'd be nice.
Okay, and I'm not much of a furrier. I don't have any furs, but I've worked a little bit with a furrier one time.
Right.
And they've got a product they call like sheared beaver or sheared mink, and what they do is they'll take a skin that's otherwise a little imperfect, and they'll shave it, cut the fur real soft, real short.
Right.
And it just makes it incredibly soft. But if you take a sheared mink coat and feel it, it feels an awful lot like a cat or a rabbit.
Mm-hmm.
Let me tell you what's disgusting about this situation. If you take, and you could use cat fur to make fur coats out of, just like you can use rabbit fur.
Nothing wrong with that.
Now, you take a baby rabbit or a baby cat,
mm-hmm.
and you put it in a cage, and you raise it, and you feed it, and you might have to take it to the vet to keep it healthy so its skin will be pretty, so you'll have a pretty coat when you make the fur coat. The time you've got these little suckers grown up and fat, you've got a pretty good amount of money tied up in them.
Right.
Why don't somebody figure out a way to skin those little suckers without killing them so they can grow another fur for you?
Hmm. What a thought.
Now, can you imagine? It could be an endless cycle. I mean, if we cut off part of our skin, it'll grow back. Why not raise these animals where you can actually skin them and let them grow another fur and skin them again?
That's heavy-duty thinking.
I mean, you would have all kind of money saved,
mm-hmm.
because you wouldn't have to grow them and fatten them up again.
Wow. So you could grow your own coat, more or less.
I mean, I'm telling you what you could do. You could take 10 cats and probably put fur coats on half the population of a city. If they could, if you just figure out a way to skin them without killing them.
For a while, they might be kind of tender and everything.
Yeah, but it'd be like a callus. After you bowl a while, your thumb gets tough and it doesn't even hurt anymore.
Right.
People walk around barefooted because they let their feet get tough.
That's ingenious. I like that concept a lot. I feel like you've taken the ball and you've ran with it. Yeah, that's it. Why not? Why not? Right?
You know something else? These folks talk about animal rights.
Right.
Most of these people who are animal rights activists are pro-abortion. You ever think about that?
Never thought about it, but I'm not talking abortion. I will not talk abortion.
Well, I won't either, but I got one more thing to tell you.
Go ahead.
Think about this. The rights that you have aren't rights that were given to you. Nobody gives you rights.
No.
You have to take them, right?
Right.
Well, an animal can have any rights he can take.
Right.
He can eat me. He can have the right. But
that's
otherwise,
right.
He's subservient to me, and he exists solely for my benefit. If he's pretty to look at, he's there for me to enjoy to look at. If he's good to eat, I should eat him. And if his fur will keep me warm, what other possible benefit could it be unless you happen to be able to eat a fur-bearing animal? Now, that would be the epitome.
That is 100% male thinking, and I appreciate it, Preston.
Okay, listen, I enjoy your show, Dave.
Thank you, Preston. That is everything he said is me. He rep that's my thinking. That's my 872-0750 outside of Atlanta 1-800-WSB-TALK. I'm David Paul. This is AM 750 WSB.
Sunday, the Falcons fly again.
This time into New Orleans.
Look out, Saints.
We're going to have to beat you one more time.
Join us for all the action, starting with the tailgate show at 11:05. Remember, you'll enjoy the game more if you turn down the TV sound, use that mute button, and hear Larry Munson and Jeff Van Oates exclusively on AM 750 WSB.
Care. In hurricanes, droughts, earthquakes, monsoons, floods, and war, when the world cries help, CARE is there. Please be there for CARE. Please. Call now, 1-800-242-GIVE.
Not everyone who calls Wes Mitter agrees with him.
Decided I'd talk to a real honest-to-God, in-the-wool, dyed-in-the-flesh, whatever they call it, liberal basher.
Oh, okay, go ahead.
What's the deal here? You right-wing conservative fanatics have been...
Wes Mitter.
Things.
He's live and local, weekday afternoons 1 to 4 on AM 750 WSB.
Well, give me some specifics here, Bart. So far, you're like every other liberal. You weave all over the highway. Tell me, give me some...
Buy from the source. The gold and diamond... source.
Sale priced every day, and this week is no exception. Stop in the Gold and Diamond Source today and take advantage of the huge savings on quality gold and diamond jewelry.
Vibrant colored gemstones.
Andy, hey Andy, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Yeah, I want to talk about the makeup thing.
Sure, go ahead, Andy.
Some of these people look like dogs. I mean, the women.
Dogs? Well, I don't think that has anything to do with the makeup.
I mean, like, you walk around, some of these women have great bodies and everything, and they have a good face, and they smother it up with makeup.
I agree with that. You don't need makeup, right?
Right.
Thank you for calling, man. I appreciate your limited little opinion. Really do. Let's go to...
Hey, this is great. I listened to the guy before you.
Paul Gonzalez?
Yeah, and I listened to you